Hi everyone. Well, today I wanted to share a little garden tour in April with you. It's spring, it's been super hot here. We've had a lot of rain over the past couple months and the garden is going crazy. In fact, I'd probably best describe it as being a jungle. Well, I wanted to start out here in the front yard first though, because I've had a lot of questions. People want to see the succulent garden that I planted a couple of years ago. So let me just turn the camera around here and show you what's going on. This front yard area was a big, huge mess a few years ago, and Laura over at Garden Answer helped me design this little succulent garden, which has been super great because it's low maintenance. I have so much to do in the backyard that sometimes I don't always get out here. So I'm really happy with how this is looking. I recently just kind of refreshed it, added some new mulch, and then up in here, I planted some kale. And now this area gets full sun. It's on the south side of my house, so it just absolutely cooks out here in the summertime. So I did kale because it's super low maintenance and it also is very heat tolerant and cold tolerant. And I absolutely love how this is looking. It's growing in, and I just harvested a ton of this kale about a week ago for Easter, and you can't even tell. I think this is an ornamental kale right here, which I think is absolutely gorgeous. I love it. So I've got some purple kale. I don't even remember all the different varieties I planted, but it's looking good. And I think that plant right there might be maybe a cabbage or a Brussels sprouts. I'm not too sure. But anyway, I'm really happy with how that's looking. And I just love this little orange flower here. I think this is so pretty. I'm not even sure what that's called, but it's some kind of succulent type flower. And then over on the other side, next to my front door here, I've got some lavender going. And I love that this lavender, it just smells so, so good. And the bees love it too. So it gives me a nice little breath of lavender as I walk in my front door. So that's the front of my house here, guys. I know I don't show the front of my house too often. Of course, I've got my favorite red door. Camera guy actually painted that for me a couple years back, so I really like it. So let's head out back and we'll see what's going on out there. Well, out here on the deck is one of our favorite places to sit. It's like a little, I don't know, place to relax and enjoy ourselves at the end of the day. So let me just give you a look at this. And we got our little chimney over there. Some of you have seen that on our videos, and we like to come out here in the evenings and just sit and relax. Sometimes light a little fire, but it's a nice place to hang out with friends. And like we've talked about lately, we kind of relax and enjoy the garden. But the containers out here on the deck are loving the spring weather. I absolutely love this container. Kind of the purple theme going on out here. These purple lubella flowers, some scarlet kale, some broccoli here. Don't know if this broccoli, it may end up going to, or bolting and going to seed, because now it's getting hot. And then my pak choi, starting to flower and go to seed. And oh my gosh, I love these flowers. The bees love them. And leave some of your plants in that bolt, because not only do the bees love them, like I said, but you can collect seeds from them. So the wallflower saddle planters here are growing beautifully. And here's a quick little look at the small space garden. We'll be doing a video on another second video on this weekend, adding drip irrigation and installing the plants. So that'll be a lot of fun. Now, something I haven't showed you guys much over here, I planted these citrus trees, I don't know, maybe a month or so ago, and I'm super excited. I have a lemon tree actually down in my garden that hasn't done too well, but these ones are looking really good. Maybe it's because it's a little bit more shaded in the mornings, gets the afternoon sun. But here's something exciting. Look at this. Got some limes. And then this one over here is a lemon tree, starting to flower. Pineapple sage. And what I love about these trees is I get a little whiff, that wonderful citrus whiff, when I walk by. So that's a lot of fun. Okay, let's head down to the garden now. Come on, Mac. Mac's gonna come with me. Go check things out. I don't think I can walk down the stairs backwards, so. So yesterday was 90 degrees. Today is gonna be 87. So I do have the garden, some of the garden shaded with some shade cloth. It seems way too early for shade cloth, but there you can see the towers, the lettuce towers, strawberry crepe towers are shaded. And this might give you just a little bit of a bird's eye view of the garden here. So I've got this, the deck up here. Then we walk down the stairs. And into garden goodness. So this lettuce tower is shaded, but I've got to uncover this because there's a lot going on here. So I'm absolutely loving these towers here. The lettuce has just grown in very well. It actually got a little bit toasted yesterday with the 90 degree heat. So you can see some of the leaves are kind of brown. I've been keeping it well watered, but 90 degrees is just pretty hot for lettuce. But I think it kind of looks fun. Some of the plants are bolting, sending up those tall stalks, and I'm really liking these yellow pak choi flowers. I just think they're so pretty. So we're gonna be building another tower on our small space garden, and I'm super excited because you can grow so much in these towers. They're a lot of fun, and oh look, oh my gosh, little berry here. That's always fun. So around the other side here, in this planter, the nasturtiums are going crazy. In fact, they're kind of taking over the backyard. So I'm definitely gonna have to trim some of this back to make room for some other plants, but I'm really liking the look of this. We've got mint right here. You might have remembered a couple months ago, I trimmed all this mint back completely to the sticks back here. I mean, it looked like absolutely nothing, and it has grown in absolutely beautifully. And oh, you guys have to smell this. Can you smell it? It smells so good. So we like mint in mojitos, is one of our favorite drinks. Oh, it smells absolutely heavenly. I wish you guys could be out here with me. So it's so much fun to come out here and just wander around. This nasturtium has a mind of its own, and it starts, let me show you, way over here. And I kind of want to train it to trail all the way up over that wall and to fill in this area. So we'll see how that goes. But let me show you around in here. Got some cilantro. Hopefully the cilantro will last in the heat, but that cilantro was planted, started indoors, and then I moved it outside here, growing beautifully right there. Just had some of that last night on tacos. And here I've got some little, I think it's like a purple cabbage. I can't remember exactly what I planted, purple cabbage, maybe some other like Brussels sprouts or something like that in there. And my peas here on this trellis are giving into the heat. You can see they're all drying up. They've got powdery mildew, but I'm gonna leave them on because I wanna collect the seeds from these. So don't be worried if your peas start to dry up in the heat. They like the cool weather. So typically what happens is they'll start drying up from the bottom and then just kind of working its way up like this one is. And don't be panicked. It just means that the weather's a little bit too hot for them and they're just kind of done. So you can try planting some more or just leave those in and collect the seeds. So when you collect the seeds, these pods will dry. And just let them dry right here on the pea vine, and you can open them, crack them open, and you've got yourself some free seeds. So it's pretty cool. So in here we've got some sage that's starting to flower, and I love the look of this purple sage. It's absolutely beautiful. More lettuce going to seed. Yesterday was super windy, so this lettuce stalk is just about ready to, I'll probably pull that out because it's kind of in the way here. But I wanted to check out, oh yes, I wanted to check out these strawberries down here that have pretty much just rooted themselves right in the ground. Look at those berries. Oh my goodness. Those are some of the largest berries I've ever picked. Those look beautiful. This is gonna be nice eating here. I really should save some for Drew when he gets home from school because he loves berries from the garden. And since he doesn't eat too many veggies, I like to try and give him some of the berries. Oh my goodness, there's more over here. Wow, look at these berries. Oh, those are gorgeous. And of course, I didn't even bring a harvest basket out here with me. Oh, these are pretty. I don't know that I've ever picked such beautiful berries from the garden. Look at that, what a nice handful. Beautiful. And look, here's some more. This tower is covered in shade cloth. And look at this cluster. This is so much fun. What a harvest. I wasn't planning on doing a harvest video. But these are like the most perfect berries I've seen. Beautiful. So just to give you a little perspective here, that's the tower I just picked the berries from. And here's the garden bed that I just came out of. And you can get a good look at the nasturtiums and the back of the strawberry towers. I mean, it is absolutely lush. The nasturtiums are absolutely beautiful. I love the different colors. This dark orange one, here's like a light yellow one, and a lighter orange. They're absolutely stunning. I mean, I'm gonna have to cut them back eventually, but it's like a nasturtium carpet. It's just crazy. And here on the towers, there's some gorgeous chard. Now, I do like to plant greens that will be good in the cooler weather and in the warmer weather. And chard is one of those that will last through heat and through cold. Some more kale in here. The pak choi is a beautiful green. It does pretty well in the heat as well. Looks like we've got some bugs munching on that. And the strawberries are weaving their way in through there. But these towers have been absolutely a ton of fun. I planted some strawberry spinach, I think it's called. I think that's this one right here, is a strawberry spinach in here too. I thought that would be kind of a fun variety. But let me go around the front, because these towers, you can grow so much food in them. And I've tried to plant different colors. Here, the purple kale, which I absolutely love. I think it's actually a scarlet kale, is what it's called, but it's just so pretty. And then this one's really pretty. It's called a red vein sorrel. So I'm looking forward to that growing and tasting it. And then down on the front here, the spinach is loving its spot right here. I've never been able to grow spinach very well because it tends to bolt very quickly in our heat, but this seems to be a perfect spot for it. And I think the nasturtiums are kind of shading it, which really helps. And around here, you can see these towers are just filling in. And as I back up here, you can see the beautiful nasturtium carpet. So it's crazy. Now let's move on to the pepper planter, which again is getting overrun for nasturtiums. I think I might have overdone it just a little bit on the nasturtiums. What do you think? So it's going crazy, but I think it looks really pretty with all the flowers, but I am gonna have to cut some of them out so I can fit some more peppers in. So the peppers actually are doing really well in the heat. These are the little sunshine chilies, which are super, super, super hot. And these teeny, teeny, tiny Thai chilies are really fun, but believe me, you want to go easy on the Thai chilies. But I do need to clear some of these out and make room for some new peppers that are coming in. Now back here, I've got a tomato plant and it's starting to yellow, and I've got to get out here and get it trimmed up. So yeah, that one's not looking too good. But down in here, the cool part is, look at here, some tomatoes. This is so exciting. I love fresh tomatoes. And this plant overwintered, so it's pretty cool to have some fresh tomatoes coming on. I wanna take you over to the veggie pod, because there's a couple vegetables over there that are a lot of fun, and I've been saving them to harvest so I can show you. So let's open her up here. Okay, it's looking good in here. Okay, this dill. Oh, I wish you guys could be here to smell everything. This dill is absolutely beautiful. Can you guys smell that? So it is starting to bolt just a little bit due to the heat, but that's okay because that'll give me those nice dill heads, and maybe we'll make some pickles or something like that with them. But and let me just show you over here, this cabbage, this Katarina cabbage. It's gorgeous. I picked one last week. Probably pick that one and make some kind of salad with it, like a Thai chicken salad is super yummy. So in here we've got some Mizuna mustard greens. Again, these are starting to bolt just a little bit due to the heat, but this is the veggie I've been super excited about. This is called kohlrabi. You might have seen my picture on Instagram, but it's almost like an above ground radish or turnip, but I've got a couple ready to harvest. Oh, look at these. I can't wait to try them. People say they taste just like a, kind of like a broccoli stem, but a little bit spicier. So we're gonna pull this up. That is one cute vegetable. Got another one back here. These are so much fun. And People have said pick them when they're about the size of a tennis ball. So I think these are just about right. I've got one more over here. Wow, we're gonna have fun with this. Ah, there we go. Those are the funkiest vegetables I've ever seen. Well, this is gonna be a lot of fun to take these into the house and maybe chop them up into a salad. Maybe I'll pick some spinach too and add some strawberries to it. Wow, coming out in the garden, you never know what you're gonna find. So moving on here past the veggie pod to this garden bed here, and would you look at those sunflowers? I absolutely love, love sunflowers. And this one actually is a volunteer. Just came up from last year and reseeded itself, and it is going crazy in the heat. I actually cut some and took them in the house the other day, and oh, these are so much fun. But here is my nasturtium wall. Kind of crazy, right? But man, is it ever beautiful. I also have some peas in there, again, that are drying up due to the heat. So those will be pulling out very soon, or maybe I'll just let them dry up and harvest the seeds. And then down in here, there's a variety of things going on. Some purple Brussels sprouts, broccoli, I'm not too sure what those are. Again, the purple kale, which I absolutely love. Oh, here's some bees buzzing around. The nasturtiums are great bee magnets. See if I can get our little friend. He's underneath the flower here. Come on, little guy. Oh, there we go. Well, anyway, the bees are great. Love the nasturtiums. And here we have another nice little garden surprise. Some tomatoes. Oh my goodness, look at that. I will definitely be coming back out here after I get a harvest basket and picking some of those to go in my salad today. So that's a lot of fun. Now moving on here to the smart pots deck is what I call this area. I love this purple raised bed here, and we've got some tomatoes going on in here also. These I believe are the patio choice, the yellow patio choice tomatoes, an All America Selections winner. So those were here all winter long, doing really well. And I just put a new plant in, another patio choice, which have some tomatoes. And I'm really liking the look of this different multicolored kind of garden bed here. Some violas, kale, some of the Paris cause romaine lettuce, which holds up very well to the heat. So I don't expect that to bolt with the heat. Got some purple carrots going on in here. Let me see if I've got some carrots that are ready to pick, because that would be kind of fun too. These might be kind of small still, but they are so pretty. Oh, look at that color. That is gorgeous. I'm gonna have a really nice salad today. And then over here, I've shaded this garden bed because of the heat. Today it's supposed to be in the 80s, so I'll probably leave it on one more day. But let me just give you a quick little peek at what's underneath here. A lot of lettuce going on here. Got some red romaine, Grand Rapids, some Mizuna in the middle there. And look at this freckles lettuce. I think that is so, so pretty. So I like to plant different kinds of lettuce so that my salad are beautiful multicolored salads. It really just makes it fun. So this is the garlic over here. We planted on video, I think in the fall. Doing really well. You can tell some of the leaves are starting to kind of brown up here. Now you want to harvest garlic when about 3/4 of the stalks are brown. So you can see I still have a little ways to go on this. Got some eggplant going on. And these are the sun patients, which do very well in the heat and in the shade. Oh, and then over here, guys, look at this. Remember the massive eggplant? This massive eggplant plant is going strong and is producing eggplants already. Those look absolutely beautiful. Now I haven't even looked at this plant for quite a while, so I don't even know if there's any massive ones under here, but there are quite a few eggplant. Oh my goodness, a little bit small, but I'm gonna have to get out here and harvest. Wow, there's a ton of them actually. Look at this. I haven't even looked at this plant for quite a while, so I need to get out here and harvest. This is pretty fun. So one last little spot here on the tour, and that is the hill. You can see it here behind me, and it's actually pretty overgrown right now. I really need to get out here and pull some of the things out so I can plant some tomatoes and cucumbers and other things like that. But I know it's sometimes you get busy and it's hard to get out in the garden. If you guys are like me, I know you feel my pain. So down here we've got a couple tomato plants. This is the Arkansas Traveler tomato. Planted this in the Spring Garden series, very heat tolerant tomato, so that's doing really well. I can see some nice new growth on that. And the Siberian tomato, which is a cold tolerant tomato, so it's kind of nice to have the variety of the heat and the cold. And if you need a bee magnet in your garden, plant borage. The bees love this plant. They're buzzing around here like crazy. And it's actually an herb. It has kind of prickly leaves. You can actually eat the leaves, which I've never done because the prickliness, it kind of bothers me, but you know, if you like it, great. But anyway, give that a go. And then we have another nasturtium fountain right there and more borage. I mean, it reseeds itself like crazy. This is all borage in here. So sometimes you end up having to pull stuff out. And then down in here, this lettuce. All these were planted, I don't know, maybe a month or so ago on a video or 6 weeks ago. Got our jalapeno peppers in here, doing really well. Some other peppers. The peas are starting to climb up the trellis. Now I succession planted peas, so some are just coming up and some are dying off, which is a great way to continually have a harvest, to plant seeds, transplants, always be planting something in your garden. So let's head upstairs now. We're gonna wrap up the tour. More nasturtiums. This tomato has overwintered. This is a, oh my goodness, what's the name of it? I forget the name of this tomato, but it has been producing bits and pieces of tomatoes for me all winter long and is just now starting to really bust out the tomatoes. All kinds of tomatoes. It is a gorgeous tomato. I'll put the name of it in the video description. I'll look it up so that you guys can plant it if you want a really good producing tomato. So here is some white clover. I planted this for a cover crop and it's producing absolutely beautiful flowers, which the bees love as well. Some purple potted peas here. I just love these peas. I think they're so, so pretty. You see those? And unfortunately in here I have a lot of weeds popping up because of the rain that we've had in the past month. I'll get out here and pull those up. My wildflower border is just starting to bloom over there along the fence. And oh, I love these flowers. These are also another good bee magnet, the red clover. So you can see here, things are going crazy in the spring and we're getting ready to turn things over in the garden and put in some of the warm weather crops. So I'm loving how things are looking right now. I'm loving the green lushness we've had, the green lushness after the rain we've had. But I am gonna have to make some room. So I'm gonna have to make some tough choices, which is gonna be kind of hard to pull out some of the things that have been growing over the winter and put in some of the fresh new veggies. One more little spot to show you before we close out the video is this area over here where I have my compost bins. I haven't really shown this for a while, but this little pile here is where I throw everything that is in, you know, that's the old food and everything, the food scraps. I just kind of throw it out in here. And then this bin here is my finished compost. And then these two bins are in the process. So when this bin finishes, I'll move it over into this bin. Then I'll add material from the wire bin here that's covered with the white plastic back over into the Smart Pots composter. That way I always have a continual supply. Well, I had to run inside and get a basket so I could pick some of my beautiful garden goodness. I just love these kohlrabi. I think they're so, so pretty. And these strawberries, oh my goodness, absolutely amazing. And I've got some kale and chard in here. It's going to be a nice lunchtime salad. Well, thanks so much for watching the garden tour. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Oh, and one last thing. Remember the grapevine I pruned back? It's the first time I actually pruned it right. Well, here it is. It's branching out. It's looking good. I am so excited to have some grapes. I just can't wait. So Max, say goodbye to everybody. Thanks for joining us on the tour, guys. It's been a lot of fun to hang out in the garden. Leave me a comment below. Let me know what you're planting right now. And also let me know what videos you'd like to see this spring and summer. All right, guys, see you later. Bye-bye.